Welcome everyone to the Defender for Cloud in the Field. The usual reminder to make sure that you are subscribing to the Microsoft Secure Channel. I'm gonna put the AKA link below. And again, thanks very much for your audience. We are releasing constantly new episodes. And today we will continue our journey to talk about the different enhancements in Defender CSPM plan. And more specifically, we're going to talk about agentless container posture with our great guest, Shani Freund Menscher. Shani, thank you very much for being on.
Hi, Yuri. Thanks for having me. Really happy to participate.
Shani, before we start, this is your first time here, so welcome again. Give us an overview about what you do for Microsoft.
So I'm in the container security team, which is part of Microsoft Defender for Cloud. I'm part of the team since September and been mainly focused on agentless container posture, which we will discuss shortly. Other than that, we're also cooking up some improvements for Defender for containers, making the experience frictionless as possible.
Yeah, Shani, she works with my great friend Maya. Maya has been on the show many times, so I'm glad that the plan is expanding and we are bringing these capabilities. Now, this, as I mentioned in the beginning, this is part of the Defender CSPM, is that correct?
Yes, so the Defender CSPM comes to solve the problem that many security teams are handling with, which is the large volume of security issues raising and not always enough resources to solve them. So we're basically providing two tools, the Security Explorer and the Attack Path. These tools are meant to help visualizing and prioritizing risks in customer environment. Both of these tools are based on a graph with context engine, which collects information from customer environment and other resources. And then based on this graph, we have the Security Explorer that lets the user query on risks on his environment. And we have the Attack Path, which basically wraps up the most important risks and visualize how an attack would look like in a user environment based on the current configuration.
Okay. And since we are talking about the agentless container posture, what is really container-related capabilities that you are bringing to Defender CSPM?
Yeah, so for containers, these tools are extremely relevant due to the architecture of the containers and the fact there are many inner components within them. So we have few relevant capabilities. The first one is really the discovery and the visibility of these inner components, like the ingress, like the pods, and so on. The second capability would be the image scanning results. And I would emphasize that not only seeing the results, but seeing on which inner components it's affecting. So if previously we would be able to say it affected a specific image or a specific container, here we can drill down to the inner components like the pods of the data plane, which is quite exciting. The third capability are insight and risk hunting. Insight are predefined security situations which we thought that are important for a security analysis. For example, a pod that is exposed to the internet or privileged container. And then based on those capabilities we just mentioned, one can go risk hunting and in his environment and search for scenarios he's interested in. The last capability would be, again, the attack path that kind of wraps up and some this information from the graph and visualize how an attack would look like in a user environment.
Yeah, that's a very long list of capabilities. So congratulations to get this out of the door. I'm pretty sure that you worked pretty hard to get this out. Can you give an example of how the attack path looks like?
Of course, if I could, we'll have a more detailed demo later, but if I can just share my screen, if that's okay.
Yeah, go on.
We have here an example of internet exposed Kubernetes pod, which is running in a container with high severity vulnerability. And here we see the components. So from the right side, we have the image. And if we're clicking on it, on the light bulb icon, we can see it is based on the recommendation from the image scanning that a container registry images should have vulnerability findings result. If we were looking here towards the middle, we have the pod. And again, if we're clicking on the light bulb icon, we see there is an insight mentioning this pod is exposed to the internet. And here in between, we have the additional components that are composing this attack path, like the cluster, like the ingress, like the container itself. So you can really see the way it works in your environment.
All right, so this is part of Defender CSPM, but can you give a little bit more explanation how this works behind the scenes?
Of course. So when one onboards to Defender CSPM, he should verify that the two relevant extensions for container are enabled. We have one extension for the discovery and visibility. It's called Agentless Discovery. And there is additional extension, which is a vulnerability assessment. And he should just verify those extensions are enabled, and he's onboarded to the plan with no additional dependencies. In this way, we can utilize all the agentless advantages here in the posture plan. Agentless have many advantages. For example, no need to install an agent, no need to maintain the agent. There is no dependency in the workload owner for permissions, and it's less resource intense, meaning there are less worries about CPU, about memories. Yes.
That's amazing. I love, because it's very frictionless. I'm pretty sure that you're going to show how this the onboarding process during the demo, but as a really good enhancement. In which environments is this supported?
So currently we're working on Azure Kubernetes clusters as well as Azure Container Registries. But we're already looking into multi-cloud, AWS, and GCP.
Okay, that's great. All right, so let's go to the demo and take a look on the end-to-end experience.
So here we are in the main blade of Microsoft Defender for Cloud. I hope all our watchers are familiar with this page. If we want to onboard, similarly to other plans, we're going to the environment and settings blade. We're choosing the subscription we want to onboard to, and then we're choosing Defender CSPM. We should click on the on button. So once we clicked on the on button for Defender CSPM play, we should basically go to settings and verify the relevant extensions, which are Agentless Discovery for Kubernetes and Container Registries Vulnerability Assessment are enabled, and then click the save button.
These settings are enabled by default, is that correct?
Yes, for those who are now joining Defender CSPM, these are enabled by default, but those who are already enable it before MS Secure, they would have to go in and enable them manually.
That's a great observation.
Yes. So after we enabled the plan, like we said, the attack path is where a user should start with. For those of you who are not familiar with that, from the home screen, we will click on the recommendation blade. And then on the top bar, we see we have attack passes count. We would click here. And we see we have one attack path here that is relevant for containers domain. It is internet exposed Kubernetes pod is running a container with high severity vulnerability. On the right side, we can see the affected resources like the pod, the image, and so on, and how many times this attack path was triggered. I will now click on it to see more details. I will say in the meantime, there is an additional attack path relevant to containers also discussing exposure to the internet and vulnerabilities, but on the host level rather than on the pod level. So like I mentioned earlier, these are the components that are composing the attack path. One thing I would like to show additionally is that if we click on an image, we can click on the recommendation itself and then see all the findings that are relevant to this image. And when we're clicking here on one of those findings, there are the remediation steps. So our user can fix the issue and complete the cycle. Other than the attack path, we also have the Cloud Security Explorer, which holds many capabilities. From the home screen again, there is a new blade just for it. It's called Cloud Security Explorer. For those of you who are not familiar with it at all, we do have some templates here. Those that are relevant for containers are marked with a purple icon. And if we're clicking on Open Query, it opens up the template. But today I have something else made for you. I'll just let it load. A different scenario. So let's imagine there's a new zero-day vulnerability, something like OpenSSL or Log4j, and the security admin wants to know how it affects his environment. So he would have to start. Here you can use the categories or just type the component you're looking for. We would start with the image, and then we would like to find out those images affected from this zero-day vulnerability. So we should know the number, the CVE number. And then we would like to know on which containers and on which pods it's affecting. So once we're clicking on the search button, it will take up till 2 minutes for results to show up. It depends on the query complexity, as well as the amount of subscriptions that are filtered into this environment. But I can tell you the Security Explorer always works the same, meaning the top bar, you're composing the query, and in the bottom part, you see results.
That was way faster than 2 minutes, for sure.
Yeah, so here we have the pods that are affected from this vulnerability. We can see there are 19 results. I think this is quite exciting to see this granularity of effect. So we didn't stop in the image level or the container level.
This is really going deep. That's amazing.
Yeah, so really having visibility into your entire Kubernetes estate. And I think this is something exciting that customers would find useful. We hope so.
Absolutely. I love this. Love the integration, the seamless experience, the onboarding process, super easy. So congratulations, Shani, for this great release. It adds a lot of value to the overall Defender CSPM story. Any final consideration before we wrap up?
If we have time, I would like to show another scenario.
Yeah,
if that's okay.
Let's go. Might be useful. So is the time all yours? Let's do it.
Great. So the scenario I wanted to give is a pod that is being on a node where there is an additional pod that is running on privileged container. This could be risky if the container is breached, because then basically it has access to all the pods on the same that are on the same host, on the same node. So let me clear that and start from scratch again. So basically, we would start with the pod that is kind of the victim in our case. And we would like to say that it is being run by a certain node. Which is running those additional pods, which is container that is, of course, privileged container. Until we have result, I would just say privileged container is one of the four insights we mentioned. We have also pod that is exposed, pod that uses the host network, the privileged container, and images that are vulnerable to remote code execution. So four types of insights that we currently have. And basically here, great, we have the results. So we can see the pods that are being affected from this privileged container. And if this container is breached, it's a risky situation that a user should resolve.
Outstanding. And the beauty about all this and the result is that no agent is required to bring all these results, right?
Exactly. Completely agentless.
Amazing. Amazing. Love it. Thank you very much for taking the time. So this is out right now. If customers want to try, go ahead and enable the Defender CSPM plan and try it out for free during the trial period and validate the scenarios. Any final recommendation that you want to share?
Just go ahead, enable the plan, play with it, and reach us out if you have any comments.
Yeah, again, if you have any feedback, make sure to use the AKA link below that I'm going to put for the user voice. There you can suggest change or share your feedback about a particular feature or plan. Shani, thank you very much for taking the time to record this. I truly appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you for having me. Super happy to be here.
It was great having you, my friend. All right, everyone, this is a wrap for today's episode. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. That way you can receive notifications when new episodes are released. Again, the AKA link is below. And thank you very much for your time. I'll see you again next time.